What's up, model brats? It's Pichu God here. So today we're going to start a new series called What If Goku Was Half Spartan? So before you get confused about what Spartan means, if you played God of War series, you will know about Spartans being one of the races which lead the, they be in the front line when the god wants to battle other gods or something. Yeah, they are just pawns. But here I'm gonna change something. I'm gonna make Spartans a race, just like Saints. They are in appearance wise, they are like Saints and humans, except they have something inside them which I'll go deeper into the episode. So without any further ado, let's get watching. So on planet Vegeta, a boy is born named Kakarot. His power level is 10,000, which shocks everyone, even the prince of the planet. Prince Vegeta was not at a power level of 1,000. Prince Vegeta's father, King Vegeta, got wind of this, and he told the guards to prepare a meeting with Bardock, a low class Saiyan, who was the father of Kakarot, to meet his child. Bardock got wind of this much earlier than what King Vegeta got. So he rushed back from his mission and went to Gine's side, who is a Spartan but disguised as a Saiyan. How, you may ask? I'll tell you in the episode. Bardock is confused about how Kakarot, his son, is over 1,000. Even his elder son Raditz was not this much. Bardock was confused about how Kakarot would be this strong, but then Bardock looked at Gine, who was sad. Bardock didn't understand and asked Gine about what was bothering her. She sighed and said that there's something that she needs to tell Bardock, and she had been keeping it a secret for a long time, but I think she needs to tell her. Bardock was confused, but after seeing Gine's serious look, he sat down and asked about what the secret was. Raditz, Kakarot's big brother, was on a mission with Prince Vegeta and Nappa. So, Raditz really didn't care about his brother being born, so he was just continuing the mission. But Bardock was surprised. Even Prince Vegeta didn't know that Kakarot, a low class Saiyan, was born at a power level which was higher above him when he was born. Now sure, Vegeta surpasses Kakarot in the present, but who knows, when he grows, he will become stronger than Vegeta. But Vegeta doesn't know about Kakarot's potential. Then, to Bardock and Gine. Gine says that she is from a different race, not a Saiyan. This confuses Bardock and asks Gine to elaborate more in detail. Gine says that she is from an extinct race called the Spartan race. They were a race in which their appearance, their physiology were just like the Saiyans, but they had something that Saiyans didn't: their rage boost. Their rage boost were consists of two forms: lightning boost and red boost. Bardock was confused, but asked what did that mean. Well, Gine really didn't know what the red and white mean, but according to what her mother told her before she died, the Spartans, it depended on all the rage which the Spartan holder conveys, which means where if Kakarot releases a certain amount of rage which he can't handle himself, he'll go into a particular color, blue or red. It depends, but because blue is the weakest of the both of them, because it can be you, it can be controlled, but the red is very hard to control. And her mother said that even the most legendary Spartan warrior, Kratos, had difficulty controlling him. He had to train for several years, and then he couldn't even master this form. So she was worried about Kakarot. Bardock asked about why she came to Saiyans, and then Gine explained that her planet was extinct by a guy named Beerus, who proclaimed himself as the god of destruction. But my mother got wind of what Beerus was going to do, and in emergency she sent me at the age of 15. And when I landed on the planet, there were many people who suspected me. They thought I was Frieza's goons or something. So they tried to hunt me, but I managed to hide. And then Bardock asked about how she was able to hide till now. Then Gine continued, saying that she had an ability of two things. She had two abilities. Illusion and power suppression. Bardock was confused about what these both were. Gine explained that by power suppression, she can hide her power, or else she can hide her power to a minimum level, so she is not susceptible. And so Gine, and because Saiyans have tails, Gine should also have. So she used her illusion magic to be like a Saiyan, a physiology like a Saiyan, a tail like Saiyan. Bardock asked about her real identity, her real name. Gine said that her name was Gine. There was no change in it, but her appearance was different. Bardock asked to show her appearance to her. Then Gine did. Gine was a muscular woman, but she had no tail. Her power was incredible, even without the illusion magic. Bardock sensed that her power far surpasses him. Then she went back to her sane form and asked, Gine apologizes to Bardock for not saying this. Bardock smiles and hugs Gine and says that he didn't love her just because she was going to work with him. He loved her fully. Maybe because she wanted to protect herself, she didn't reveal the secret. But now, since she need to protect her son, she told it. But then, Bardock asked another question. Why didn't Raditz get affected with this? Gine was confused. Because she also was confused because she didn't know the answer to it. She thought that hybrids will get the same potential. But no. Only Goku got it. I mean, only Kakarot got it. But no. She didn't know why Raditz didn't have potential. And they talked about more things about Guinness, and their bond grew even bigger. And then the next day, King Vegeta came to their little house, demanding to see Kakarot. But Gine had planned for this, because due to Gine's high race, she was able to sense ki, and was able to understand that she was able to understand that King Vegeta was gonna come and check Kakarot, because King Vegeta got the wind of Kakarot being at a power level of 1000, which would agitate him. So she used her illusion magic on him to make his power level of 10, an average power level. Then at front of they showed where Kakarot was in a sleeping capsule, and then they checked his power level, which was 10. They were shocked. Bada shot him, but he saw Gine and she winked at him. Bada chuckled himself to himself where no one could see. And then the thing visitor asked about what his power level was at birth. Gine said it was 10. And even Vegeta was suspicious of Gine, but Gine showed a brave face about not giving any suspicions. And because of her talent in hiding things, King Vegeta believed, and he just went without even saying sorry for interrupting the day. And all this 3 years passed after Kakarot was born. Raditz met Kakarot, but he wasn't interested in him because he was he wasn't as strong as Kakarot. But Gine really didn't care about Raditz right now. Even Bardock didn't care, because Raditz was with Prince Vegeta, his behavior started to change. He was becoming colder towards his newborn brother. All Raditz wanted, and even they asked Raditz about why he was behaving like this. But then Raditz said that if his brother is not him to him, is not as strong as him, then he's ashamed to call his brother. Bardock laughs, and Gine laughs too, saying that you're underestimating him. Raditz is confused, but he says you will soon find out what I'm trying to say. But that soon will come later. And then the next day, Planet Vegeta dies. Planet Vegeta has exploded. Kakarot is sent to Earth. And here comes something. Goku still has the ability to turn A, but due to his hybrid form, his hybrid gave him a sense. He could sense ki, he could control his rage. I mean, he couldn't control his part in the red color one, but he could control his blue color one, the blue lightning one, not the red lightning one, but the blue lightning one. But that is in the future. So he lands in Mount Paozu, where Grandpa Gohan meets him. But this time Goku is not a rowdy child, because Spartans were considered to be a hero type. They were used for wars, but they didn't treat the children like killing machines. They treated the children as a children. Yeah. So Kakarot wasn't rowdy, and which meant he never hit his head. So he remembers that he's a saint. Because I think that guy's 3 years old, so I think he would remember his name and his race. But he also remembers something his mom told him. He is one of the kind, a Spartan, a half-breed. And his mother told him to keep this a secret. But he only says that he's a saint, because that's more common. Because Gine told him, her planet was exterminated, and she was a lone survivor, and now Goku is. So Kakarot to reveal her, reveal the other part of Goku's nature. And since Goku remembered his Kakarot name, his name would be Kakarot, because I don't think he would be named as Goku. He still would be named as Goku, but he would protest that his name is Kakarot, because Spartans are intelligent. Saints have muscle. But the Spartans are intelligent as well as has muscle. And due to Goku knowing suppression techniques, because Goku knows he doesn't know the illusion technique, but he knows the suppression technique. Because his mom teased him. You might guess what a 3 year old learns knows this much. I mean, Gine wouldn't teach him, like not train him. She would talk through the incubator. And Goku, who's pretty smart because he has part inside in him, would understand. And he would try out regularly. He would start to fly, which impresses Gohan. And Gohan would ask Goku to show his full power at the age of 5. shouts, which explodes. His power is 1900. Gohan is shocked. Grandpa Gohan is shocked. What kind of guy, what kind of being is he? Is he from a god race? But Goku tells that he really doesn't know that what his sane people are. They might be stronger than him, they might be weaker than him. But Goku lacked knowledge of martial arts. When Goku asked Gohan to spar with him, due to his rubbish nature, he just brute forced everything. He didn't know martial arts. Sure, he defeated Gohan, but he didn't know martial arts. He just punched and kicked and that's all. He didn't know any skills. This made Gohan realize, what if he could train this boy? He started training. And after a year, the full moon appeared and Goku saw it turning into a giant ape. Gohan was terrified. He thought he was gonna die. But the great ape was just standing there. Gohan doesn't know what to do. He shouts at the great ape, calling him Kakarot. Kakarot turns and sees Gohan and waves at him. Which means Goku has complete control over his Ozaru. And when Gohan senses his ki, oh my god, he's just like, wow, this guy's like, he's in his 50,000s. Not 50,000s, he's in his 12,000s. Which was amazing. And so the years passed with the normal things happening. Where Goku meets Bulma, he goes to collect Dragon Balls. And there's something which never happened. Because Grandpa Gohan is there till Bulma comes. So Goku knows some respect. He knows about being nice to girls. And I think Grandpa Gohan would teach him about marriage and stuff. So when Chi-Chi tells Goku to marry him, Goku just says, no. And yeah, he just goes off. She wants to pursue Goku. She wants to impress Goku. She wants her love of her life. Anything. She doesn't care about anything right now. So yeah. And the Peel of Saga, Goku just one-shots everybody. Even Yamcha is no match for him. Yeah, even Peel of Gang, whose power level is stated to be 40. A lot more than Yamcha. Is no match for him. Then next comes the map. Then Goku trains with Master Roshi for a year. And Goku really doesn't need to get launched. Because Master Roshi knows who Goku is. Because Grandpa Gohan recommended Goku to Master Roshi. His nickname is Goku, but his real name is Kakarot. But his nickname is Goku. They still call him Goku, who was closest to him. Then Krillin comes and he still uses his book to bait Master Roshi, and that works. So Krillin and Goku start training, but Krillin soon realizes that he's way out of Goku's league. Goku finished everything that Master Roshi did for him in just one day. And the same to Krillin, because he wanted to surpass Goku, it took him 1 month to finish what Goku had done. Even Krillin pushed beyond his limits. Then he realized he can do nothing. Goku is far superior to him. And Master Roshi, seeing this, decided to do training himself in secret. Using his secret training which he used in Dragon Ball Super. Which made him grow a bit. And because Goku had a strong partner. Not Krillin, but Master Roshi. Because Goku would insist Master Roshi should spar with him. And yeah, and even if Master Roshi trained he just trained not catching the eyes of Goku and Krillin. So I don't think it would be drastic. Jackie Chan would be not that drastic, but still he would be powerful than what he is in the normal canon. But in the 21st world martial arts, Goku dominates everything. Even Chi-Chi applies, because Why wouldn't she? Chichi applies, but no avail. She couldn't even go past the second round. But Goku dominates. Even he dominates Jackie Chun. So you might be wondering, is Goku gonna be cocky? No. Master Roshi, in the year of training Goku, always told Goku that he should never take the power to his head and to remember that it is always stronger than him. But Goku really didn't get any challenge, but he still wanted, you know, he really didn't care about a challenge because he was overpowered right now. But he kept in his mind to never take the power into his head, and he just did that. And then we come to the Red Ribbon Army Saga, and well, that's really nothing to change except Goku never trains with Karin because Goku one-shots Mercenary Tao, the Red Ribbon Army, completely defeating them. And even Goku, for safety measure, waits a day. You know, if there's someone, survivor, he would wait, and since Ki, he would get one, Dr. Zero. And he would go and defeat him. But this time, he would send all of them. Not all of them. Yeah, except for Dr. Zero. Because Zero, he knew something was up with Zero. Due to what Android 8 said about Zero, he was the one who created the bad mechanics. And if he went to jail, who knows, Goku, he might come back. And which means he might take this revenge sort of thing. So Goku, on the spot, finishes him. Yeah, that's the first death. That's the first kill that Goku ever got. And then we come, Goku, you know, goes around the world asking tips. And many suggest him to climb the tower. You know, because there's a legend that his god is there. Goku knows flying. He just flies there. And one more thing, Goku never gets the Nimbus because he's just flying. Why does he need the Nimbus? So Krillin gets it. Yeah, I just wanted to add that. And Goku trains for 2 years with Korin because Korin really doesn't have to he just teaches him basic techniques about what he could do, you know, blowing Senzu beans to manifest Senzu beans or some skills like that. And then we come to the 22nd martial arts tournament, which Goku dominates again. And this time, even if Tien Shin Han is there, I mean, Goku has a power level of 2500. Who would win? Even Raditz couldn't do anything. Yeah, which means Goku dominates it again. And then comes King Piccolo. By this time, Goku is able to sense him far away. And when Krillin goes to get the power pole and the Dragon Balls, Goku just says that he should not go and tells Master Roshi about what he's sensing. An evil energy who was in his lay, who is old, but has evil in it. Goku, Master Roshi just thinks and figures out that it must be Piccolo. But he wants to verify his suspicions. So he tells Goku to battle him, but not kill him. Because I think Master Roshi would know if Piccolo died, the Earth Guardian died. And if the Earth Guardian died, no Dragon Balls ever. So Goku would go to Piccolo, bash him down, capture him, and wait for Master Roshi to come. He would come and he would try to use the Mafuba, but Goku would stop and asking what he is doing. Master Roshi would say that he is going to seal Piccolo. But Master Roshi was training all this time to, you know, try to catch up to Goku, Goku says that he is going to do it. Master Roshi is surprised, saying he was going to say that he can't handle it, but then remembers Goku's power level. And then King Piccolo is just right there, can't do anything. He's just standing, his mouth wrapped, his hand wrapped, everything, so he can't even throw an egg. And then Goku learns it immediately. Goku uses the Mafuba and seals Piccolo. and puts the seal on it. And yeah, then the Karin communicates with Roshi to tell Goku that the guardian of Earth wants to meet him. Goku is surprised. And he's like, sure, why not, and flies upwards. And reaches Korin, and Korin says to go more upwards. Goku sighs and goes upwards, and then he meets a guy who's Piccolo, but he doesn't attack him. He senses this guy's energy, which is pure, and that guy was evil. Kami thanks Goku and tells Goku to train. Goku does. But due to Goku knowing about the great Ozaru form, I mean, he used against Gohan, and because Gohan is alive, he would tell Goku about the Ozaru form, and since he has perfect control over it, then why not just train his tail? And for the 3 years, Goku trained his tail, his mind, body, blah, blah, blah. All that stuff would happen, and then comes the 23rd Tenkaichi Budokai, Chi-Chi coming again to try to impress Goku, but in the second round, Goku just waves and she just goes out of the stadium. Everyone is shocked, and Goku reveals Goku is just wearing weighted clothes, and his power level, Master Roshi says, in way suppressed, is 1000, and then the final match between Tien and Krillin, I mean not Tien because Tien lost to Goku, Krillin and Goku. Krillin was training all this time, rigorously, not even stopping, and wanted Goku to go full power. Goku threw his faded clothes, so jump around for a little bit, and went full power. Everyone was shocked. Goku's power level was over 7000. Krillin was over just 400. Krillin was no match for him. Just shoved Krillin up, but said that they could train together. Krillin knew that Goku was a saint because he told Goku, but he still felt defeated and jealous that Goku was the one who got this power and not him. But now that Krillin has this offer to Goku, he accepts. Sure, why not? And then they train for 5 years, and then Raditz comes, which we are going to continue in the next episode. So that's it, guys. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, subscribe, do the necessary stuff. And if you don't, end this time. So till then, peace out.